evening, friend. I will do the $10 challenge of meat, chicken, giblets, heart, and wings. And I will attempt to do it two dishes. Okay? With the dry one and with soup. So we will see what will happen. So let's do it now. Okay? What I have here is the giblets, the heart, and the wings. I think this one is 1/2 kilo. All of them are half. And it costs only $2.50, $1. And this one, I think $3.99 a kilo. And these are the spices. So, okay, we will start now. I'll do first the dry one. So this one is garlic, onions, another garlic, onion, tomatoes. This is the lemongrass from my garden. This is the chives from my garden. This is the calamansi. Calamansis from my garden. Okay. What we will do with the giblets is chop with small pieces. Okay. Slanting. We will do it thin so that it's it will cook quicker. So just do it like that. And anyway, I am using a very nice premium. What brand is this? Sharp knife. It's really good. You will cook once in a while. It's okay. The giblets and the heart. If they're a nice meat, nice food to eat, and they're yummier than the meat itself. So yeah, don't be try to experiment something because it's economical also, and they're nice. Actually, the taste of the giblets and the heart are nice. I prefer it than the really lean meat. Once in a while, it's okay. So don't be afraid or scared to experiment because me. Everything is experiment. I don't follow the books. I follow what I want. So maybe we will try a bit for that one. If like for example your kids don't want giblets, you just cut them like small pieces so that they will not notice it when they are eating, and then you will trick them. Same with the heart, just dismantle it or disorient them. What do you call that? What's the term? Cut them so that they will not notice that they are heart or they are giblets. And this one is even 6 people. You can feed 6 people with that $10 budget. I will cut the wings into smaller pieces. So what I did is cut here, cut there, and the winglets is for Ollie. And we have to cut again. Smaller pieces. So this one, remove this from the joints and cut this one. Yeah, this one. Mini drums, you have to cut it too. Like that. Again, this together for the dry. I don't know what's the name. It's like. Giblets, I don't know what will you give. Maybe we will think when we will finish cooking. And this one is for with the long melon. And this one is for Ollie. So we will give it to Ollie. Okay, Ollie. Ols. Come on. Come on. This is your food. Eat there. Don't eat outside. Okay, this one I will prepare with my vegetables, chicken soup. Can you hear that? Also enjoying his winglets. And this one is for my garden. There's my straw. I want it bigger. Yes. Yeah, again, our practice so that we will not waste any food. The leftover, we'll just keep it in the fridge and we will eat it again the following day. Or you can just put them in the freezer and you can eat it after another day, the other day. But yeah, it's our practice to do like that so that you will not be wasting any food. I'm now here in the stove. We will start now to saute this dried dish. Be using olive oil. With dry food, it's good to have more oil, so that because the oil will be the one to cook the meat, because you are not putting any water, you are not adding water, so that means you need more oil. Okay, we will add the onions. And now the meat, the giblets. We will put together the heart. This one is still too much, a lot. Black pepper, we run out, so we'll just put the, we'll just use, put some of this in the bag. And I said, put some sauce. Again, it's like, it's the color. When I am putting soy sauce, the color and the taste. I don't really measure it. And you can put also a bit of patis. Pati, I always use patis because it makes it nicer. The flavor will make it nicer. There's a bit of soy sauce. I patis. Okay, this one, we will cook this until it will dry up, and we will taste afterwards. While we are waiting to tenderize the meat, I will cut some of this calamansi to get the juice, because I want to put in there. In that what I am cooking, because I want it a bit salty, hot and soury. It in half and squeeze it here. When after cooking, you just put this one so that it will not cook, and then the flavor, the freshness of the calamansi, you can still taste. We will use also this chili powder. I want it a bit spicy, hot, So we'll use this. Okay, we'll back here again to mix it. So you don't really need to put water because it will water and that will cook itself. Okay, as a mom and as busy as always, so while cooking you can also do other things like cleaning, sleeping. It's easier, economical, you don't use energy, electricity. With this listing thing. We have vacuum cleaner, but it's still a hassle and you still use energy. So you can use this. And this is half away. It's almost now. This one is almost, the sauce is almost gone. So you can taste now and adjust again the flavor. Mm. So it's like it's okay. Sauce. A bit of white paper. Garlic powder so that it will be spicy. That's the main thing there. If you will make it spicy, put more spices. Can you put this tanglag? Okay, I pick chili from my garden and this parsley from my garden. Garnish. Oh, na lang dito.
Oli. Fried shallots.
Time we will cook the second dish for this $10 challenge. It consists of chicken wings and long melon. Opo with these ingredients: shallots, chives, tomatoes, onions, garlic, and this time with ginger and olive oil. Okay, I'll saute again because of the chicken, but this time with this a little bit of olive oil, not much. You can put the and this one is just so that's why I don't need to put a lot of spice because that dry dish is already too spicy, so this one is just light and refreshing. this. Paper over it, and then it will simmer, and the juice in the fat in the chicken will come out. Then that's the time we will check it in. Okay, this one it's been like sauteed, so it's the oil is coming out already. So we will add water now. That's the water for that, and then you will put, if it's boiling again, you have to taste the saltiness, and then you can put this long mirin already. Tips, just put the meat, the vegetables, and don't stir yet. Just stir it when it's almost cooked. When you think that it's already cooked, okay. Oh, it's been cooked. See, you can mix now. A little bit, pa. And then we will put this. Okay, that's it. It's yummy. I've done my cooking, so I don't know. We did not time it, tell how many minutes we cook this one. And we cook it one after the other. Shh! Only? No. So, this is the dried dish, and this is with the soup, and I'll keep this one already here because I know that this would be over for tomorrow, and maybe still here 2 half of this because we're only 3 eating here, and this one we just put it here for the good presentation. So yes, this is $10 challenge dish. Okay, thank you friends. I hope you like what we cooked today, and maybe try it too, and cheap. Very cheap, and it seems yummy. So thank you. Up to now I don't know yet what's the name of this dish, so we just leave it like that. Okay, thank you friends. Good night.